Hello, my name is Eric Klein with Analog Devices, and I'm a product applications engineer working with A2B. In this presentation, I will discuss and demonstrate some of the exciting new opportunities for A2B going beyond the automotive market. A2B is an audio communication bus that reduces interfacing complexity by delivering up to 32 channels of bidirectional audio, I2C and SPI, and the latest generation of broad market transceiver. Up to 50 watts of power can be supplied over a single twisted pair cable with a node-to-node distance of up to 30 meters and a total network length of 300 meters. The audio connectivity demands of the modern recording studio are accelerating. From professional facilities to home studios, countless devices and peripherals need to be seamlessly connected. A2B will simplify and streamline the process using existing cabling that is already in hand, making integration faster and easier for the end customer. The live sound industry thrives on its ability to set up and break down a sound system quickly and reliably. With the daisy chain topology of an A2B network and our plug-and-play protocol, there is more flexibility and less cabling, which will decrease setup time and improve repeatability. The integration of conference room peripherals and commercial audio-video systems is only going to increase in complexity. A2B offers a very robust and expandable solution for interfacing all types of sources, speakers, and controls. With node-to-node daisy chain connections over a number of possible connector and cable types, including Cat5, installation costs is decreased while making the system more serviceable and upgradable by using connectors and cables that installers already have the tools and supplies for. To help demonstrate the advantages of A2B, we are going to focus on its key features. Multi-channel bidirectional audio. Recording studios and live sound systems often have dozens of sources and destinations with many different communication protocols. Low latency. Latency is a major issue on the stage as well as in the studio. Artists need to monitor their performance through headphones or stage monitors, and any audible delay can negatively impact the artist's ability to perform. High power. In the past decade alone, the amount of digital signal processing and audio peripherals has increased exponentially. With these power-hungry devices and the need for multiple subnodes on a single network, a high-power solution is critical. Single twisted pair. XLR and Cat5 cables are ubiquitous in the studio and stage. Professionals already have cases full of these cables. A2B's ability to utilize existing cabling makes integration into existing systems simple and cost-effective. To demonstrate these features, we chose to build a personal headphone and monitor mixer. This type of device is common in the professional audio industry and is familiar and simple for customers to use. It has a main unit with 8 analog inputs and 6 individual A2B main nodes. Those 8 channels go through one of our Sigma DSP processors and then onto the A2B bus, where they are distributed downstream to the subnodes. In each of the subnodes, there is a smaller Sigma DSP with built-in codec that uses its aux ADCs with hardware potentiometers to control the level of the 8 individual tracks and sum them together. The output is routed to 2 high-current headphone amplifiers, each with their own level control. Each subnode also has a microphone and talkback button. This push-to-talk feature unmutes the microphone that is routed back to the main node DSP, where it is combined with the 8 downstream channels. Pushing the talkback button on any subnode utilizes the GPIO over distance feature, enabling that microphone channel while reducing the level of the 8 main inputs and activating an indication LED. Finally, each node is connected by a simple and ubiquitous analog XLR microphone cable. These are cables that can be found in any studio and on any stage in the world. Here we see the subnode connected to the main node by only a single XLR, which is daisy chained to a second unit. There are 6 potentiometers to control the 8 inputs, 2 stereo and 4 mono, and 2 output controls to control the 2 headphone amplifiers. Individual levels can be controlled, showing the multi-channel nature of the bus. Including this microphone that you're hearing me on, I can raise and lower the volume on that. So here we have stereo drums, stereo organ, mono bass, mono guitar, this vocal mic, and of course, some cowbell. And we can raise and lower each individual track to our own taste. So if I wanted to hear drums and maybe just the bass, and I was mad at the guitar player and wanted him very quiet, I could keep him quiet. Mix in some organ. And of course, if I want more cowbell, I can always add more cowbell. Great bass playing there. Pressing this button, a signal is sent to the main node that is then sent back to all of the subnodes to indicate that a talk button is pressed, as we can see here on this node. The inputs are reduced in volume to allow the talkback audio to be heard. This allows the musicians and engineer to communicate even when other microphones may be off. It also demonstrates the extreme low latency of the system by giving a direct signal to the headphones that travels to and from the main node. The outputs of the headphones can produce some serious volume, which is important to many professionals. The environments can be loud, and the monitor systems need to compensate for that, highlighting the high power capabilities of the system.
Thank you for your time, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation. For more information, please visit analog.com/A2B.